Bývalý člen Hnutia pravdy, dnes znovu zrodený kresťan. Mário, presvedčený hlasateľ New Age učenia, kedysi podvedený falošnými doktrínami, túžil poznať skutočnú pravdu. Hľadajúc únik od psychickej a telesnej bolesti, zažíval duchovné peklo, z ktorého sa chcel vyliečiť a oslobodiť skrze duchovné praktiky New Age. Liečenie čakier, meditácia, reiki, transformácia vedomia, zaoberajúc sa východným mysticizmom, venujúc sa tarotu a astrológii, čoraz viac padal do temnoty tohto učenia. Nakoniec sa Mário stretol so svojimi tzv. Duchovnými vodcami, ktorí sa zdali byť jeho liečiteľmi. Dokázal otvoriť svoje tretie oko a nadviazať kontakt s týmito bytosťami. Ako to však celé skončilo a čo prežíval na tejto ceste New Age učení, ktoré dnes zvádzajú celý svet? Pozrite si jeho príbeh.
My name is Mario, and I'm online as The Vigilant Christian, and started the online ministry about a year ago. And I've always set out to do something like this. Previously, well, as you're going to hear, I'm going to talk about, I was in the truth movement, so I've always been kind of wanting to get the truth out there and wake people up. And somewhere along the line, I came out of the New Age movement, became a born-again Christian, and now I'm trying to preach the gospel to as many people as we can and just bring people to the truth. Being a seeker, that's been my goal in life, to truly know the truth and to seek it out. And that's what you're going to hear in my story here today. And I do all sorts of different work. I'm going to be doing a lot of stuff, exposing the New Age movement, talking about my different testimonies on my channel and the different things that I went through. And so definitely go and check that out. And so very excited.
Yeah, we'll put links to all of the various places and stuff in the show notes of this show, and we'll also mention that at the end of the talk here. So why don't you go ahead and get started and tell us about your testimony.
Perfect. The thing where I want to start in my testimony is obviously growing up, I'm a French-Canadian, and I grew up in a Catholic home, and I think that's significant to point out in telling you my testimony, just because that's kind of like the taste that I had of Christ in the very beginning of my life. I would go to church and you get this kind of weird feeling. There's a weird vibe in the Catholic Church here. And I just kind of associated that to Christianity, to the Bible at a very young age. I was very turned off. And later in life, I started to rebel. And, started to ask some very deep questions in life. I didn't want to follow authority, and I didn't know why things were the way they were, and this pushed me to truly ask some very deep questions. And this is probably in my teen years where I started to ask, who am I and what am I doing? And a significant event for me was actually September 11th and everything that went on there. So that kind of opened me up to the truth movement, and that's really where I started, because I was starting to ask, all these deep questions, and here's this movement, okay, it's about the truth, so we're discovering some things. So I definitely got all into that, and because of that, there was a lot of New Age movement things that I was discovering through that. And this was happening simultaneously in my life at a time where I was experiencing depression, anxiety, and a lot of hard emotional and physiological and psychological problems. So, looking at these New Age things, I was like, well, this can bring me healing, and this can, give me understanding as to what's going on. So I started to really kind of look into the New Age, and, like I said, I was having all these problems with my body, so I came across some information about the Dark Night of the Soul, and I was able to really relate to that material, because I was actually being tormented. It was like an absolute spiritual hell, and this is really what propelled me into the New Age movement and the different practices. I viewed the practices and things. I would go to, get light work done and chakra healing and balancing and, all those practices to try and heal what was going on. And it was like I would do one therapy and then, everything would be fine and my energy would be balanced, quote unquote. And then it would put something else would get off balance and, I'd be forced into more, even more deeper understanding of, Reiki or meditation or, this whole idea of transforming my consciousness. So it was really related to like a physical experience too. I even wanted at this point to become a yoga instructor, signed up to become a yoga instructor, so studying the Bhagavad Gita and really getting into Eastern mysticism and philosophy, heavy into tarot and astrology, and just, all the gurus and the New Age teachers, the Deepak Chopras and the Eckhart Tolles, reading The Power of Now, and, I was just really, really heavy into this stuff. I, found myself experiencing an awakening, a big transformation, and it was what I believed to be a rebirth at the time. And it was just, at the time I thought, well, this is it. This is what I'd been searching for because I'd always been a seeker. And this is probably 3 or 4 years into it. I really wanted to take it to the next level. And at this point, this is when I had read a lot of material about, spirit guides, the ascended masters, and the channeled information and people who are being used as channels. And I was like, that's where I want to go. I want to, if there's a being who can, who's at a different dimension and understands, higher wisdom and knowledge, and it can communicate that to me, then I definitely want to be part of that. And I had read that psychedelic drugs could be used in a way to open yourself up to that experience. So that's what I went. And I do want to clarify here, this isn't like drug use like at a party or anything. This isn't like recreational drug use. This was shamanistic, using psychedelics to open myself up to have that communication with that spirit being. So that's truly what I did. And the first time I did make contact, I did it. And one of the beings that appeared to me came to me as Archangel Michael. And if you're familiar with me or Chris talking about these issues, demons can masquerade themselves as angels of light. So that's the form that this being took to come and to deceive me. It came to me as Archangel Michael, and it told me about okay, there's 2012 coming, and there's a big shift in consciousness, and that's what you experience is this God realization, and that's what all of humanity has to come to. And at the age of Aquarius, we're all going to transcend. And all this information that if you really look in the New Age movement and the Truth movement, you have people like David Icke and David Wilcock being channeled, they're channeling that same information. I was being told the same things. And to clarify, when you communicate with these beings, this isn't like normal communication. There's different ways that I would communicate with them, which would be, clairaudience, which is the ability to hear them, or claircognizance, which is just that deeper knowing, and clairsentience, which is feelings. And there's different ways, and I would do this through the tarot cards, and that was another powerful way to communicate with the spirits and have them, communicate what it is I would go to study next, because as they're leading you, they're synchronistically through like these crazy spiritual, supernatural experiences, bringing you to what book to go to, what person to talk to, and you're being supernaturally led by these beings. So it's a very, very powerful experience. So that's basically what I was going through. And these beings, I do want to clarify, they really deceived me. They were beautiful in the very beginning. They came to me with all this wisdom about, this now I recognize it's New Age and occult wisdom, but it seemed so appealing, and it was so wise, and they were so beautiful, and they were there to help me heal and understand myself and all this stuff. So I never even thought of the idea that they would lie to me or that they would be deceiving me until a bit later. And this is when I actually stumbled across a YouTube documentary called The Age of Aquarius, The Age of Evil, which Chris White is actually featured in. So I definitely recommend anyone to check it out here on YouTube. It's definitely eye-opening, and that's the significant point where all of a sudden I start asking myself something that I've never asked before, could these beings actually be lying to me? And, to find out that all my beliefs were really rooted in New Age and theosophical beliefs, and that they're at their root Luciferian, that really opened me up to, okay, wait a minute, I could be deceived here. These could be fallen angels. And once I started to have that realization, that was very scary, actually. For the next 3 weeks after I saw the DVD, I went through a huge demonic attack, because at this point now I'm asking my spirit guides, who've been there for me. I got 30 of them at this point. I'm communicating with them, and they're helping me in my life, and they're helping me evolve through different levels of consciousness and all this crazy stuff. And then I'm asking them, guys, like, is this for real? Like, who's Jesus Christ? Because at that point in my journey, Jesus Christ was just an ascended master. He was just an avatar. He was just like the other Buddha, and he was, we're all trying to achieve that Christ consciousness. But then I'm starting to look at Jesus Christ is presented in the Gospels, and I'm seeing a different Jesus here. And when I presented that to my spirit beings, they weren't happy with that at all. What were beautiful angelic beings turned very demonic and very vicious, and I experienced some demonic attacks. I'd be laying in bed, and I'd get sleep paralysis because I couldn't move. They were just on top of me. It felt like I was being choked out. This happened a couple times, and other times I'd be just hanging out, after a workout, making a protein shake, and I would see, because I did a lot of third eye meditation, so I'd have a very vivid ability to have visions. I'd see in my third eye this little gremlin-looking thing crawl up my leg and shove my face in the blender and be like, "Satan owns you. You're never gonna go. He owns your soul." And I'm just sitting there making a shake here, so that's pretty freaky. So at this point, I'm going, what did I get myself into? What have I opened up? I'm really crying out to God. I remember I got on my face and knees, and I cried out to him, and I said, "You have to help me. This has gone too far. This is it was the torment was too much." I had this overwhelming sense and feeling that, I had I had went into a place I shouldn't be anymore, and it was very important that I come back home, and I had to get away from this. So the very pr probably 2 weeks after all this was going on, I went to a local church. There was a charismatic preacher there. He preached the gospel of Jesus Christ, and talked about the cross and how Jesus died for my sins. And it was at that moment I remember, all those years of seeking and everything that I'd been through. It was just that was it. There was no more seeking anymore, and I had just found it, and I had found it in Jesus Christ. And when he says that he is the only way, that truth was revealed to me then through the Holy Spirit, and it was just that was it. I was born again by God's Spirit, and I just knew. I knew at that moment, that's it. This is what I've been looking for. I couldn't find it in Eastern religions. None of these spirit guides could teach it to me. No meditation, no crystal, none of that stuff could truly give me what I had found that day. So I accepted Jesus Christ, and awesome thing is, after they had a prayer line, and when you open yourself up to these spirits like this, they're not going to let they're not going to want to let you go very easily. And I experienced a battle right there. I went up to a prayer line, and a girl comes up to me, and she just basically looks at me, and she goes, "You've been into Buddhism. You've been talking to spirit guides." And I didn't even know this girl at all. So right then and there, I'm going, okay, well, if she knows that right there, okay, well, this is something God wants to do. And she's like, I need to pray for you." So she starts to pray over me, and instantly I just manifest. This force just comes in, and I felt like I could have just grabbed her and pushed her like 20 feet. That's how strong I felt, but there was something blocking me, and my eyes were rolling in and out of my head, and one part of me was calling out to Jesus to come, and then one other part would come and say, "I'm not letting him go," in this very demonic, weird voice. And this was going on, and people were praying for me, and after it just came out. It came out of me, and I remember I was just crying, and it was just a powerful experience, and I just started following God from that moment on. So, that was just because when we open our, I did the channelings. I opened myself up, and I allowed the spirits to auto write through me and stuff like that. And I just remember the feeling of them not actually being in my body, and this was a huge thing because it just felt like I was clean. I remember this feeling when the Holy Spirit was there that, I had allowed these beings to work through me, and it wasn't right. It just, that was not their habitat. They were not supposed to be there. And then now God was dwelling in me, and His Spirit indwells me. And I just remember that being an awesome feeling. And then since then, things have been awesome. Jesus Christ is, like I said, what I've been looking for. I got baptized on December 21st, 2012. That was actually something significant for me. I believe that day. I was like, you know what? Like I used to tell people, December 21st, 2012, it has to happen. We have to evolve or else, this isn't going to happen. And, we had all of our beliefs on, oh, the poles are going to shift and all of our different reasons. And, and to be saved, I was saved in January 2010. And then, it took a little long to get baptized, but, it just fell perfect that day. That's it. There was no transformation of consciousness. There was no big event. So we can kind of see the channeled information that I was receiving and other people were receiving is false, and that just goes to show you that that's what it is. This information that you're receiving through the spiritual realm that way, it needs to be tested. We need to test everything, and that's just false information. So I got baptized on that day, and that's the true transformation of consciousness to me. You're looking for the mind of God. Well, that comes in and operates in you through the Holy Spirit, and you want to ascend. That doesn't happen other than when Jesus Christ comes at the resurrection. It's all counterfeit spirituality, and it's appealing, and they just have a way of deceiving people. So I hope this testimony helps people. I hope you come to Jesus Christ to really to get to know Him. If you're looking into these things, it's because you're seeking. There's a part of you that is spiritually void and is looking to fill that. And those who come to Him will never thirst again. And they're going to find that spiritual fulfillment. And there's only one place to find it, and that's Jesus Christ.